Well, my friends, you just watched me play a draft. I had a teamer deck that I was pretty happy with. I tried my best, but alas, I was defeated. So what we have here is a redemption draft, round number two, and this time I'm gonna have to go 3-0 for sure. Opened a much better pack than this time with one of the strongest uncommons in the set, Bane Whip Punisher, and one of the strongest cards in the set, period, Unesh Cryo Sphinx Sovereign. Even when you don't get any other Sphinxes, this is just like way above par card. 6 mana, 4/4 flying, already powerful body, and then getting to factor fiction, probably better than drawing two cards. This is just a bomb. Never pass it. So I'm gonna take that. I'm gonna expect the person to my left to take the Bane Whip Punisher, and we'll see what happens from there. Strongest cards in this pack are Hope Tender, Tenacious Hunter, Green Desert, Puncturing Blow. I'd say I'm choosing between Puncturing Blow and Tenacious Hunter. I guess Tenacious Hunter is a good fit. Having a six drop rare is exactly the type of scenario that I described last draft, where like I have my payoff card if I get to draft the Oasis Ritualists and Gift of Paradise type cards. So I'll go with Tenacious Hunter. And Green Desert to follow up. If I hadn't taken a green card yet, I would take Ifnir Deadlands because it's a little bit stronger than the common deserts, but might as well stick on color at this point. Oh, hello. Strong pack. Overwhelming Splendor is another card that pairs well with a bunch of Oasis Ritualists, but it is a third color, and I don't have any of that mana ramp yet, so I'm hesitant to take that when I have other good options. Otherwise, Beneath the Sands or Wall of God Pharaohs, Forgotten Pharaohs, pairs well with what I have. Or I could branch out and take Vile Manifestation or Lethal Sting. I do like Vile Manifestation quite a lot, and it's early enough in the draft that I might be willing to speculate on it. Slightly unfortunate that I passed Bane Whip Punisher and will be passing Lethal Sting here also. But I don't think I'm gonna let that scare me away. It's a tough pick. I could see an argument for Splendor, Manifestation, or Wall. I'm going to take probably the strangest of those three options and take Vile Manifestation. It's just a sort of a pet card that I like quite a lot. I'll follow that up with Lethal Sting. Black feels to be quite open from my right, though maybe downstream I'll have created a black drafter. Otherwise, I'd be taking Wall of Forgotten Pharaohs here. But given that I took Vile Manifestation, I really do think I should take the removal spell. Now, haven't really seen a blue card since my first pick, but this is a bomb rare that I'm loath to give up on. I could just completely do a 180 and take Unraveling Mummy and go from drafting blue green to drafting white black. Doesn't sound too great. Harrier Naga Without Weakness and Seer of Last Tomorrow, those are all just unexciting filler cards. I might just take Traveler's Amulet to increase my ability to play a three-color deck. Now I'll take a Camel over an Imaginary Threats. Could have also picked up two Appeal to Authority, so I never saw a mono-white card that really appealed to me, but could have had. If I had just randomly been drafting white, I had probably two good options for a good white deck, white black or white green. Manalith. This draft is a bit of a mess. It's not looking as good as my previous draft looked after one pack. I have a few good cards, but my first three picks were blue, green, green, and I feel like those are the colors I got cut on. And probably white and black are the most open colors. Grizzly Survivor is good in the same deck that Vile Manifestation is going to be good in. And I might be hard up for playables, so I'm going to take this over Liliana's Defeat, even though I think in the majority of situations you would want to take Liliana's Defeat here. All right, another Traveler's Amulet. So I'm protected from having a complete train wreck by having two Traveler's Amulets and a Manalith, actually allowing me to potentially play three colors. I'm really not optimistic because I got cut pretty hard on blue, and now this pack I'm probably going to get cut on black after passing the Bane Whip Punisher. Don't know about green. Like, I didn't see much green either, so this I'm going to have to piece something together. Not my favorite pack. Cursed Horde is a fine card. Goes well if you have a lot of zombies. Desert's Hold, clearly the best card in the pack, but I don't have any reason to be white, but it is splashable also. And then I could take Desert of the Mindful if I wanted to really stand by the Unesh. Desert's Hold also not the best for me since I don't have deserts right now. Yeah, I don't know. I could take Desert of the Mindful and just plan to play a mostly black cycling deck and have my best card. I think that's what I should do. Okay, now I'm happy that I did it because Ominous Sphinx, great card in its own right, great in a blue-black cycling deck, and it's a Sphinx, which it could very easily come up that I get two triggers off of Unesh, which would just be ridiculous. Oh my god, Pride Sovereign? Should I go back to just drafting four color mess? This pack doesn't really have anything I want too badly anyway. So I guess I'll take it and see what happens. Well, the one thing I'm definitely not playing is red. So I'm not going to take Puncturing Blow. This is between Lurching Rot Beast and Eternal of Harsh Truths. The Eternal being the better card, but Rot Beast pairing very well with Vile Manifestation and Grizzly Survivor. It also doesn't look like I'm going to have the nice tempo deck with like Unsummons and Aerial Guides that makes the Eternal most likely to connect. So I'm just going to take the weaker card that I think fits a little bit better with what I have. Obelisk Spider, tempting since I do have some incentive to potentially move back into green, but I'm going to take Lethal Sting. Razaketh's Rite, very nice cheap cycling card for my cycling deck, and also tutor for Unesh. Ruin Rat, Countervailing Winds, Carrion Screecher. I'm going to take Countervailing Winds. Also, Desert of the Indomitable. I think I'm going to try not to get sidetracked with the green here. Just stick with the plan and piece together an average quality blue-black cycling deck with a couple of rares. This pack went really well for me. I could use a Ruin Rat. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine cards with cycling so far. Pretty good. So do I take a Tragic Lesson, which is a pretty solid card advantage spell, or do I take a, you know, situational cycling card in Imaginary Threats? If I had two Vile Manifestations, I would take the cycling card, but having only one, I suppose I'll take Tragic Lesson. I have no real desert cards. I have one Wretched Camel, so I'm not going to play a Survivor's Encampment. Just take another cycling card. Having two lethal stings makes me want to pick up some high toughness cheap creatures, like maybe a Dune Beetle would be a fine addition to my deck. Okay, Commit Memory, a not quite a bomb, but a very good rare. Wander and Death would also be pretty nice, but I'm going to take Commit Memory. Maybe I can be fortunate enough to wheel Seeker of Insight. I don't think I'll wheel Wander in Death. But it's a strong pack overall. Charioteer, Avenger, Electrify, Gustwalker, Naga Vitalist, Seeker, Wander in Death. Those are all cards that will be in high demand. So I'm looking for Ruthless Sniper, Shadowstorm Vizier, Hecma Sentinels, River Serpent, Shimmerscale Drake, Horror of the Broken Lands. This is a cycling theme deck. I'd also just take some good removal spells, Final Reward, Splendid Agony. I love Splendid Agony, by the way. I think it got a lot better with the printing of Hour of Devastation. Wow, that's another bomb rare. Yeah, I'm going to take it and I guess maybe move the Manalith back just as a two-color mana rock. This is coming together as a functional control deck. My card quality is not super high, but I've got a plan. This would have been a really nice collection of cards to play a five-color green deck, but I think I was just too cut on green. Somebody else must have been going for it, taking the Oasis Ritualists and whatnot. Grimstrider is a very strong card, but it's not at its best here. I anticipate having, like, two or three cards in my hand for most of the game. So I might need Doom Dissenter or Hecma Sentinels more. Both are pretty decent with Lethal Sting. Definitely want to get at least one more 2-drop before the draft ends. I'm going to take the Doom Dissenter. This is a perhaps excessively disciplined pick, but I think this is the card my deck wants most with, you know, if the draft was to end right now. Okay, cool choices here. Decimator Beetle is perfectly splashable off of Manalith and a couple of Traveler's Amulets. Even Initiate, totally average creature. I would take Hieroglyphic Illumination before Scarab Feast, and then Cartouche of Ambition. Also interesting, though, I don't have many great targets for it. Like, it's great on the Sphinxes. Scrounger of Souls already has Lifelink. It's pretty sweet on the Riverwinders, but that's a very long game plan. I'm going to take Hieroglyphic Illumination. And Lay Claim over Shadowstorm Vizier, though I have a lot of cards that cost 7 mana. But I think even so, it's too good. Ooh, Splendid Agony over Bone Picker and Essence Scatter. I expected to be cut on blue in this pack, but it's going quite well. Had I taken the cartouche, I might take Trial of Ambition, but I actually think Compelling Argument's probably just better for my deck. Don't have that many cycling payoffs. So maybe Naga Oracle then? Maybe Trial. Maybe cancel. I think I'll take Naga Oracle. All four of the blue cards are considerations here. I wouldn't fault someone for taking any of those four options. I'm gonna go with Naga Oracle. Wrappings for the sideboard. Nothing I need here. Maybe I'll want to destroy an artifact. Nothing I need here. Maybe I'll want a supernatural stamina. Doubtful. Maybe Board in Faith the Devoted for a really slow matchup. Ah, Scarab Feast. Playable card. Festering Mummy, I don't mind that also. Right, so let's go to deck building and see what I can come up with. First, I'm looking at my creature curve. Wretched Camel might be a little too bad here, since it's not even a good body for the lethal stings. I like all these creatures though. And without weakness, pretty bad. Scarab Feast. Playable but unexciting. Tragic Lesson. What do I want more between a Tragic Lesson and a Scarab Feast? Guess if I cut both, then that's 23. I like these spells. I like these creatures. 17 land sounds about right. I like the Manalith to get me to my 5s, 6s, and 7s a little faster. Yeah, okay. Let's do it. I potentially want a little more black mana because all my early defense is black. But I do have two cards that cycle for one blue, and my two rares are double blue. I think even considering that, I want to do 9, 8 in favor of black. Take a screenshot, save my deck, and I'll see you for round one. Round one on the play with blue-black control. That's an acceptable hand. This is a deck that's very hungry for its land drops. I have four cards that cost 7 mana. Though to be fair, I don't think I'll be casting the striped Riverwinders all that often. This hand's kind of bad since I have 5 lands and can't even cast Ominous Sphinx. Depending on what my opponent plays on turn two, I will probably cycle Moaning Wall. It looks like I'm up against a ramp style green deck. Could come to regret cycling Moaning Wall if he's got a lot of Harrier Naga type cards. That looks like an Essence Scatter if I've ever seen one. Probably passing with Hieroglyphic Illumination open here. Yeah, again, I could play the Naga Oracle, but I feel like my opponent has Maybe it's just a cycling card, I don't know. Maybe it's both. Could have cast Hieroglyphic Illumination there to play around Censor, but I would rather represent my own counterspell, I think. Sure. All right, Sphinx coming down. I'll be sure to board out Festering Mummy in this matchup. Doesn't look like it's gonna kill too many little creatures out of a blue-green ramp deck. Huh. Cycling a hippo at 6 mana? Strange. Sure. Still get a 1/1 body, and I still get the effect of -2, -0 whenever I cycle. All right, now I see why those creatures got cycled. Not too worried yet, especially because the River Winder matches up very well against those. If I draw Cruel Reality, it's the game's probably going to be over. Unesh would also be fantastic. Maybe I was a little overzealous in cycling my Razaketh's Rite earlier. Feels like this player may have been near me in the draft. I guess I'm just playing more dudes and hoping I draw Cruel Reality or Unesh before my opponent draws whatever their big payoff cards are. Lethal Sting ready if a Sifter Worm comes down. I probably just can't beat Sandworm Convergence. Sure. I don't think I have any bounce spells in my whole deck. Sure. Killing off my 1/1 flyer, that's fine. More worried about the trial getting returned. Don't know, my opponent could get decked. I have a pretty decent defense here and lethal sting to take care of any flying creature that might come out. But again, it's just going to depend if there's something like a Sandworm Convergence in his or her deck. So that's 14 cards after draw step. It's going to be 13 after the trial. It's going to be 10. So 10 turns to kill me. Can you do it? Pull from tomorrow? What the heck is this? Wow. Well, I hope you have commit memory or struggle to survive. Sure. How's this going to go for me? Ambuscade. Unsummon. Looks like it'll be fine. Yep. Yep. Gonna be patient with the lay claim. Think my best bet is probably killing the Vile Manifestation. Killing the River Serpent, I guess, maybe is more important. Okay, 5 turns to kill me from 23. So of those 11 cards, I know one is a Trial of Knowledge, which is not very helpful. Probably four are lands. So we have six cards that I have to beat. All right, I mean, I'm going to operate under the assumption that my opponent doesn't have a way to reshuffle his or her deck. And I'm just going to lay claim the sharpshooters. Probably as a bounce spell, I have to imagine. So in that case, maybe it's safe for me to lay claim the hippo. Might get counterspelled also, who knows? Four turns to kill me. Wow! My opponent conceded. I didn't have to do anything that game. I never attacked the entire game. What I do have to do is sideboard out some of my unexciting ground defense. The Ruin Rat can stay. But all these ground creatures really don't do a lot. So I want to bring in some card drawing. Illusory Wrappings looks great. And probably just more cycling cards. All right, I'll give that a try. Should be a tough matchup for me, though. The Trial of Knowledge and the Pull from Tomorrow give my opponent a big advantage in the long-term game. Not quite that long-term of a game, but you know, the medium long-term games. Sure. I don't feel a rush to cycle anything. I'll just wait and see how the game develops a little bit. All right, patience is the name of the game here. That a missed land drop? Jeez. Well, I think I will play a Sphinx and pass. Again, I think Cruel Reality is going to be my absolute best card in this matchup. Good one. Sure. Think my move is Hieroglyphic Illumination and then lay claim the hippo. Yeah, that sounds fine. Will they claim the Sphinx? Time for me to start attacking with a bit more, I think. Now I'll cast this, and I shall commit my own Sphinx. Cycle for the extra damage and to draw into my Sphinx. Then I'll cast the Sphinx, which I don't love doing into open mana, but at least if my opponent counters, he or she will not use the River Hoopoe. Aha, Drakehaven. Yes. Okay, well, I can use Ominous Sphinx trigger to prevent anything bad happening from to me. Sure. Okay, just pass the turn. So it'd be a really good turn for me to draw a non-land card. Like even a cycler would be great. So what I could do here is Lethal Sting, a Drake. All right, I mean, I think I just Lethal Sting a Drake, attack with everything. My opponent will double block my Ominous Sphinx and chump my Vile Manifestation, go to one. All that stuff is fine. Another, just like last game, I think it's going to be really tough for my opponent to kill me slash leverage the Drake Haven with only 10 cards in the library. So I think in a perfect world, I would certainly play the rest of this game without using the memory. Okay, one life. So my opponent has somewhat stabilized the board, but still has to come back from a 20-1 deficit with only 9 cards in library. All right, my opponent has seen enough, and I advance to 1-0. Welcome back for round two with blue-black control. I'm going to choose to play first, but unfortunately I have to take a mulligan. That's better. I have a really slow deck here with some late-game bombs, so really the goal is just survive and make my land drops, and then hopefully I can outpower my opponent in the late game. I would just cycle that if I drew it, which I guess would be okay because I have Vile Manifestation. I'm just going to bottom it, though. And I did draw Vile Manifestation. That's pretty funny. I'll just play a Ruin Rat for now. I may have to play the Vile Manifestation as a body to take Lethal Sting counters. Well, I'm missing land drops, but I have an impenetrable defense so far. Sure. I don't have any great cards in my hand anyway. I don't really care what my opponent takes. He or she should probably take the commit memory, especially because of the small amount of aftermath value. But I could also see taking countervailing winds, trying to mana screw me. Cool. Sure. Looks like we have a control mirror. My deck is well suited to control mirrors, especially against black-red. Like, black-red's effectively just not going to be able to beat Cruel Reality if it comes into play. I am well contented with this board stall. Ah, Grixis. Maybe I'll have to play against Nicol Bolas then. That I have a much harder time with. Sure. I could Lethal Sting that. I could cast Moaning Wall, or I could just trust Ruin Rat to hold it off for now. Start with cycling this and see what that gives me. When you play against Grixis, you gotta think of Nicol Bolas, especially a slow deck like this, defensive creatures. Sure. I shall lose 3 life. I feel like my opponent probably should have attacked with Ruin Rat also. Little inconvenient, but I think I definitely have to cast Lethal Sting. Well, this is bad. Yep. Take a quick look at my deck here. Commit Memory is already gone. So I shall cycle this and then concede. I guess, I don't know, maybe if I draw Unesh or something. I like this matchup a lot better when I thought my opponent was just red black. That's my out. All right. Can't believe I was going to concede when I have that in my deck. I mean, I'm still overwhelmingly likely to lose, especially if my opponent ever uses the plus ability, the plus one ability again. Maybe I can win. Who knows? All right, plus 2, then I steal your Nicol Bolas. I'm minus 12. Ominous Sphinx. Okay. And how greedy do I get? So, option A, I can ultimate, exile each non-land permanent my opponent controls. Option B, I can kill Ominous Sphinx, leaving Nicol Bolas with 8 loyalty. Option C, I can plus 2 and try to get lucky. I think I like the kill Ominous Sphinx option. Wonder why my opponent's not cracking the Traveler's Amulet. Think my opponent's kind of just panicking, which rightly so. I was panicking when I was playing against Nicol Bolas a few seconds ago. That's really good against the Ruin Rats here. Double Torment of Venom is definitely worth taking note of. Wow. This is a sweet deck my opponent has put together. So far, it's actually like mono black with Nicol Bolas. Yep. Soon I can just plan on minus fouring twice to kill my opponent. I gotta just find one more point of damage somewhere. Okay, this time I'll just discard. Triple Torment of Venom. Well, whatever draft pod this player was in, black was wide open. That's a nice one. Thank you very much. I will take Ominous Sphinx and Striped Riverwinder. Okay. Well, I did not expect to win that one. In fact, I was about 5 seconds from right clicking concede game until I drew lay claim. I hadn't thought of that at all as an out to Nicol Bolas. Meanwhile, going to game two, should sideboard relatively similarly to how I did in the first match with, well, Proven Combatants, I guess, pretty good against those triple Torment of Scarabs. Festering Mummy's pretty bad. Ruin Rat was pretty bad. Maybe Moaning Wall. Moaning wall over Scrounger of Souls. All right. I am going to wait till I cycle my Desert of the Mindful before I know whether or not to cycle my Striped Riverwinder. Shaping up like I won't need to cycle it, and I can just wait patiently for 7 mana. So Doomfall or discard spells in general, that's another good reason to not cycle everything right away, because I don't want to find my best cards until I'm ready to cast them, because they're not necessarily safe sitting in my hand. Sure, I'll just kill that guy right away. Think I should Razaketh's Rite for Cruel Reality. Think that's the. I mean, I could go for Unesh also. It'll depend what I draw on my turn. Sure. Going for Unesh, like, just get the clean 3-for-1. Sounds pretty good. Also lets me curve out nicely. Okay, split them up. I would take a pile of three, but otherwise I'll take the pile with Striped Riverwinder. Yeah, I think just going for the quality is fine. The quantity is fine. Especially against a deck with a bunch of torments. My opponent potentially 1 mana away from Nico B. The Riverwinder can pressure Bolas a little bit at least. And I have two incredible cards still in my deck to draw into, Cruel Reality and Lay Claim. Two like effectively unbeatable cards. Cycle Wander and Death. That feels like looking for a land. Archfiend, that's getting lethal stung. I put the counter on the Riverwinder because I figure it's very likely to trade for the Ruin Rat at some point or other. Here it comes. Here he comes. Oh, that's not Nicol Bolas. That's an 8-drop. And I just used my lethal sting. Look at that. My opponent now can use the Ruin Rat to tutor for Nicol Bolas. Holy cow. I mean, I had to lethal sting the Archfiend, didn't I? You don't let that card survive. Okay, lay claim, please. Okay, lethal sting. I like that a lot. Though I should put the countervailing winds on top. I can cycle into that. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna take eight. But I think I will win. I'm going to guess my opponent takes a draw, then sacks the Ruin Rat, goes for the Planeswalker. I cycle, countervailing wins it, then I draw Lethal Sting for the 8-8. Now, when I lethal sting, do I go for the proven combatant and eternalize right away? Or is that too greedy? I think so. I put a 2-turn clock that way. Use my mana very efficiently. That was a very good Naga Oracle. I found everything I needed. Okay, my opponent better come up with something. Okay, on to the finals. Welcome back to the third and final round. I started the day by drafting a pretty good teamer deck, but I lost the first round with that to a whole lot of Inferno Jets in a row. Now, this blue-black deck, the draft felt like it was going quite poorly for me in pack one, but then it picked up and I was able to put something reasonable together. I've had two good pairings playing against other slow decks where I think my deck kind of shines. And now I'm on the draw in game three with a one lander, but with a cycler And if I find a second land, I have two more cyclers plus some early defense. I think this is worth keeping. I get to see three. You know, if I have a land in my top three, this hand is better than mulliganing. Plus, I have two striped river winders as redraws. Depending on what my opponent plays now, I might not even cycle. I guess I should cycle. Yeah, I should cycle. Mouth. Let's cycle this. Come on, land. Okay, so Manolith plus Festering Mummy. Consideration to block the hippo and put a -1/-1 counter on it, since that will mean one less card my opponent draws with feed. But I think the mummy probably has a little more value staying in play. My opponent considering not attacking after I just said into the microphone that I wasn't going to block. All right, I mean, very unenviable situation. I can lethal sting the ritualist if I would like, but I don't really like making plays like that. I think I'm going to start by using my blue mana to cycle. And now I can play Ruin Rat and cycle the Rot Beast. Sure. I don't have to cycle the Rot Beast, but I think I'm going to. I want to get to my more powerful bombs. It's going to be a little hard for me to win a long game here, or like a fair game, I should say, because of the feed in my opponent's graveyard. So I can either play awkwardly where, like, I fire off lethal stings on middling ground creatures to keep the feed under control, or I can play more of, like, super long run game where I'm trying to get to either my flyers or my cruel reality or my lay claim where I can just go over the top. Mm-hmm. There we go. My life total's high. I'm going to play Bomb Rare next turn. My opponent has a stacked hand and a pretty good board, so I'm definitely not safe. Also, green-white has Appeal to Authority and Overcome that can kill me out of nowhere if I'm not careful. But at least I'm going to do something good on my turn, probably on my next two turns. Sifter Worm, okay. So next turn, an overcome would be 9, 15, 20 damage. I have enough toughness to survive that, so I will go ahead and still cast Unesh. Try to manage the Sifter Worm with either the Ruin Rat or just cast Lethal Sting the following turn. Bottom. Still thinking about the other two. This is some scry. Top, reveal planes. Okay, I mean, I guess my opponent doesn't need the life gain. That's potentially a very good draw. Unesh, try to find a land, and then I can play two spells next turn. I'm going to take... I mean, I would clearly take a pile of three. I probably want Splendid Agony more than any of the other spells. Sure, I'll just take the spells. So we both have good boards and stacked hands. It's going to be pretty cool to see how this game plays out. Again, I need to be careful not to get punked out by one of those deal a ton of damage in one turn type cards. This is going to be 20 damage. Oh my god. 17 trample. Oh my god, I'm dead. Oh. Okay. I could have avoided that last turn by going... Lethal Sting your Sifter Worm, Lethal Sting your Bitterbow Sharpshooter, attack for 3 lifelink. But I thought I would get greedy. Well, Lucery Wrappings looks good. Other than that, I probably don't want to change much. Scrounger of Souls is a bit undersized. So is Naga Oracle. But this looks fine. Okay, I like this hand. because it has Cruel Reality, which I think is one of my best cards, but I haven't put it into play yet. Traveler's Amulet, is that for a third color? I can cycle that because by the time I hit 7 mana, I'm going to have a better play anyway. Just thinking back, I guess my opponent didn't even need the ambuscade last game. Just tapping my high toughness blockers was going to be enough. So I did leave myself dead to appeal to authority. I considered overcome, but should have considered that also. Sure. Don't think there's much reason for me to attack with that mummy. A mountain. So could have boarded in, or could just have, I don't know, Samut struggled survive. Who knows? Either Samut, I guess. My opponent casts Sifter Worm. I'll commit the spell. Okay. Sure. Is a bit of a bluff. I would be happy to trade it with Hope Tender if my opponent chooses to double block. And it's not that high cost that my opponent would block with only the Ritualist. Trading for Hope Tender cuts my opponent by one mana, and it's also one less creature to sacrifice to Cruel Reality. This will be an interesting game also. Sure. Please work. Well, if my opponent didn't have anything good, and I know he or she is drawing Gustwalker this turn, I might be okay. The Samut can go ultimate, but hopefully there's nothing too devastating to get. Two creatures and/or planeswalker cards. Two Regal Caracals. What creatures put a bunch of tokens into play? Just two big dudes. This guy would only be a 2/4, so I actually think he's better off just getting cycled to trigger the Ominous Sphinx. Please have nothing. All right, really good time for me to draw a non-land card. I guess I'm casting Memory then. I don't like it, but I need to find a Lethal Sting. I did find a lethal sting, so a good start. I have a lot more mana than my opponent, so if I can survive this turn, there are some cards that I could be dead to, like. No, I'm probably pretty likely to survive this turn. Samut plus land compulsory rest would do the trick. Think I'm just gonna block. Next turn, I'm gonna have 10 mana, so like creature, cycle. Anything cool I can get with Razaketh's right? Creature, cycle. This is tense. I gotta hang in here like three more turns, and then I feel like I can win. This is such a great game. Please don't have anything else. Nice. Feel like there's probably a better way to do that for my opponent, like attack first, and I'm gonna have to cycle and you can respond. But I guess now I can't put my Sphinx in combat, so this might not be great for me anyway. Also didn't draw into anything too exciting. Okay, so I'm blocking the Sandwalla. We're trading. Then my opponent's going to sacrifice the Spearmaster. And I'm going to have to handle that hippo somehow. There we go. That can handle a hippo. Right, gotta hang in there. Gotta let the cruel reality do its work. There's still one more embalm creature in my opponent's graveyard. This is gonna be tight. I think I should not sacrifice the Vile Manifestation because I do have one more Lethal Sting in my deck. Sure. Man, stop playing creatures. I know I gave you seven new cards, but come on. I'm dead to a removal spell here, which stinks. Sure. All right, I really need a non-land card this turn. Oh, come on, don't have another creature. I drew some lands. Can't you draw some lands too? All right, I need something big then. Potentially very good. Okay, so I can kill Hooded Brawler and then gain two life. Need to cycle this also. Come on. Oh, come on. So close. Gonna think for a minute here, because if I click too fast, my opponent knows that I have nothing. I don't know. Basically, I need my opponent to somehow choose not to exert the Spear Master to like miss the compulsory rest thing, or I don't know. Wow, those were really, really good games. I mean, I think it was a good video. Three really close matches. I think I did what I could in this game. The first game, I did not play around appeal to authority. Maybe you could have navigated differently. But anyway, that was two pretty sweet drafts. I had fun making the video. I hope you learned something, and hope you'll join me next time here on channelfireball.com.